Hi, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today we are reviewing a pen that was sent to us by Appelboom, which is an online store from the Netherlands, and they sent us a package of pens for review, and this is one of those. So let's see what is inside. Inside we have a Parker pen, and beneath cartridge and the leaflet. That doesn't matter, let's look at the pen. First of all, it is not written here anywhere, sometimes it is, but the name of this pen is the Parker Urban Premium Orange. So, what are the first thoughts about this pen? The first one is the name. They call it orange, but this is really brown, not orange, so that's something strange to read about the pen. But let's look at it with further detail. What are the characteristics of the pen? First, this is quite nice looking pen. It has this very strong texture on the cap, which is nice. The cap is made of metal, like stainless steel cap. Then we have a barrel, which is made of aluminum, I think, and it has a ring on the end, and it has these that looks almost like a blind cap, but it is not. This is all the barrel. Then it has a shiny surface there, a shiny surface also on the top of the cap. On the cap also it has the very well known, with some variations along the years, the Parker arrow clip. The finish on the cap is really texturized. This is somehow nice to hold, and this would make an extraordinary anti-slipping grip. There's no way you can't grip this cap. This is very tactile, your fingers almost get stuck to it, so quite nice the cap. The barrel is a very smooth, I think, anodized aluminum. On the cap, on the barrel, there is the Parker engraving there. In many Parkers, this kind of engraving is on the bottom of the cap. This is on a ring on the barrel, not on the cap. When we unscrew the pen and it unscrew and sorry, when we open the cap and it doesn't unscrew, it just has a slip fit and clicks on place, we have a metal section, quite heavy, heavier than the body, than the barrel of the pen, so when you hold it, it gives you a very, very nice balance. It is very comfortable to write with. If you want, you can post the pen, it posts securely. It's not that big heavy, because the barrel gets a lot inside the cap, but it's not very top heavy, but it is a little top heavy. And about posting, as you can see, it posts securely, but it moves around, so it can be like this, and for some people this would be very strange to not have the cap perfectly aligned with the barrel. So I'll take this off. More about the pen. It has this matte steel surface. I don't find it slippery, but I guess some people may find it. It narrows down until here, and then it flares out a little bit again. And here you have a ring made of a shiny chromed metal, and there you have the nib. The nib says Parker only, and it really, for me, it doesn't sound like Parker. And although the nib does, the feed does, this is a typical Parker feed with the M engraved there. This reminds me of, I don't know, I don't really, this doesn't remind me of Parker. And I don't really like the proportions of the nib. It is too short and maybe too wide for its size. I think it could be a bigger nib, but not with this shape, a little bit longer. I think it would be nicer. So this is it. Inside, it takes the usual Parker long cartridges or two short cartridges or one Parker converter. So that's it, the proprietary Parker converters. The size of the pen. Let's just check and compare it with other pens. We have here what we usually use to compare, a Parker Centennial Du Fold, which is a little bit longer and much wider. And then we have the Lamy Vista here. So it is a long pen, nice size, really. Nice balance on the end, in the end, in the hand. But then you see the nib. I feel it has the wrong proportions. I don't really love the shape of the nib of this pen. Another thing that we have to mention, this pen is being sold for around 75 euros, and this pen looks a little bit cheaper than what I would expect for a pen for 75 euros. I have to remember the pens, some pens I really liked. And when was the Parker 45? And there was the Parker 45 Fighter, which has the gold-plated trim, the clip, and the ring. But then it was all steel, very beautiful. And it went for around 35 euros. So for me, it is hard to really find fair 75 euros as the price for this pen. I'm not saying the pen is bad. It is not. It is a nice pen. It writes well. But what I find is, except for the lines on the cap, it doesn't really have any specific design feature that remembers us of Parker. It is not outstanding in any way. And why so much? Maybe around 30 euros, and I would find that would be the right price for such a pen. I really think this is a little high. But now let's see how this pen writes. So we have here our Rhodia.pad, and let's zoom in a little and see the writing experience. As I told you, the pen fits perfectly on the hand and it is quite well balanced. Now, about the writing experience. This is a Parker Urban Premium Orange. The ink is the Parker Quink Black, and the nib is a fine nib, and the paper is the nib is a medium nib, sorry, and the paper is the Rhodia dot pad. About the nib, what do I think? I think this nib is very, very smooth, although I've not seen it with a magnifying glass. Sometimes it skips, not usually during the writing, as you can see. But sometimes it fails at the first stroke on the paper. The first of all, of course, when I'm making these reviews, I have the pen kept for a while, so this skip may happen because of that. But sometimes this pen skips in the first use. So, not so nice, although The nib then is very perfect. It's skipped a little bit here now. It puts down a nice amount of ink. It is a medium nib, but not too wide. It is a real medium, I would say. You can't have line variation with this pen. Not anything that it is right clearly visible. And you can write, this is something very common with Parker pens, you can write upside down. And the line, as you can see, is finer than the regular line. So I would say this is a nice pen, very comfortable to hold. It has a nice design. It's quite understated. You can use it very formally, but it is not that special for 75 euros, in my opinion. That is just my opinion. However, I have no complaints about the pen, except that first skip. Now it did skip. That sometimes happens. I had some people saying, I heard some people saying that this pen sometimes gets dry inside the cap, that the cap doesn't close it safely, and there are hair leaks and the nib dries. I didn't find that to happen, although I may understand that because you can see it's not that tight. It won't fall down, it won't fall off the pen, but maybe it is possible that some have this problem of drying out. I didn't find this problem with mine at all, just the occasional skip on the first line, as you saw. Now, maybe there are some adjustments that can be made to the nib and solve this, but I just wanted to show you. So, what I have to say is thank you. Thank you all for watching our YouTube channel. Thank you to Jost Appelboom for sending this pen for review purposes. And if you liked the video, please hit the thumbs up button, and please subscribe our channel to be sure you get the notifications for every video we post. See you next video. Bye.